Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how we can create email templates in Salesforce Classic. Before starting, let me share you how you can search me on YouTube. You can search my name on YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various Salesforce related videos there. So now, in setup quick find search box, you need to search for email templates. So here classic email templates option will be available there. So with the help of this option, you can create email templates. So here we can do two things. We can create folders as well as we can create email templates. So if you want to store your email template into separate folders, then you can create new folders. Otherwise, you can use these two existing folders, right? So now I'm going to create a new folder first. So name is test email templates. Then here we have folder access. So read only and read write. So I'm selecting read write. Then if you want to put any existing email template into this folder, then you can choose. Then we have a folder share or accessibility options. So this folder is accessible by all users. This folder is hidden from all users. This folder is accessible only by the following users. So as per the requirement, you can choose these options. So if you choose first, then it will be available for all. If you choose second, it will not be visible for all. If you choose third, then you can choose public group, roles and subordinates. So if you have created any public group which is having some users inside that, so you can choose that also. So right now I'm choosing first option, that it should be visible or accessible by all the users. And I'm clicking save. So the folder is created, but right now there is no email template. So we are going to create new email template. So here we have four options for email template type. So I'm choosing text. Now here you can see various options. So first it is saying merge fields. So we'll cover it later. First, let me fill these information. So here we can choose folder in which we want to store this email template. If you want to make it available for use, you can click on this checkbox. Then here we need to provide email template name. So test template. Then here you can choose a particular encoding. Then you can write description, subject. So my first email template, and here you can write the body. So I'm writing some test message. Hi, this is my first test email template. And I'm clicking on save. So this way I created a simple email template, and I have not chosen any merge field here that I'm going to use further. So first I'm going to test it so that we can see whether we can send an email to a particular user or not. So here you can see the option send test and verify merge fields. So right now we don't have any merge field, so we will only test it whether it will be sent to a particular user or not. So here you can see options contact account, or you can choose this email so that you can see whether it should be delivered or not. So right now I'm not choosing any contact or account. I'm just picking this email ID. If I choose account or email, I choose contact or account related record. So they both have email fields. So that email will be fetched automatically, and this template will be triggered to that email account. So right now I'm not choosing any contact or account, picking this email ID and clicking on OK. Right. So now we need to check our mailbox. Yeah, here you can see this email is available, and you can see the subject, my first email template. You can see the body, hi, this is my first test email template. So this way it is available here. Now I'm going to use some merge fields. So I'm clicking on edit. So I'm picking account fields. So I'm picking account name. So this can be copied directly and you can use it here. So this is an expression. It will be replaced with the account that you will be choosing. Right. So I'm picking only one field right now for the demonstration purpose. As per the requirement, you can pick any particular object from here and any field related to that object, and you can pick or copy this one and paste it in your email template. Now I am saving this. I'm opening an account first so that we can check the data. So we have this account. So account name is this, right? So let me search for, yeah, it is associated with a contact and that is also having an email. So we don't want to send email to that one. So again, I'm clicking on this send test and verify merge. So I'm picking this and an account. So I'm picking an account and sending this email template to this email ID only, because I just want to test it. And for this merge field, I selected this account, right? So here you can see now after hire, the account name is displayed here with the message. So this way you can select your merge fields. Now let me send it to a particular contact. I'm opening this. Clicking on edit. And I'm putting my email ID. So let's see what happens if I send it. So from here, I'm choosing this account, choosing this contact, which is associated with this account. So contact and account both are chosen here. Right now, I'm not picking this checkbox as true and clicking on OK. Let's see what happens now. So right now we don't have any email. So when you will be using this email template for any workflow or process builder, then you can choose that contact, and then contact email address will be fetched automatically, and then that email template will be sent to that email address, right? So we don't have this right now. So if I choose both, and click on this, then only right now we can have this test email, right? So email templates are used with email alerts, and these email alerts are used in workflows and process builders. So if you want to know how we can use email templates in workflows and process builder, so I have created a separate playlist for that. So you can watch those videos in that playlist. so that you can understand how we can use our email templates to send email messages to the users. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. If you want to watch more Salesforce related videos, you can search me on YouTube by my name. Thank you for watching this video.